Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So here we are with the third episode of Andaman Vlogs, and today we are gonna cover Havelock Island. So to know all about it, keep watching till the very end. So here we are rising up early with another beautiful morning, and now we're gonna move to our next destination, that is going to be Havelock Island. So without wasting any more time, let's begin with the journey and take you there. So to move from Port Blair to Havelock, both private and government options are available in ships and in jetties too. And for this time, we chose a government option for ourselves. We arrived onto our ship, Coral Queen. The ship had 3 floors and all the passengers were accommodated on the lower one, which is commonly called as cabin. It took us a while to find out our cabin because they were all numerically arranged, and after finding our cabin and putting our luggage inside it, we went to the deck of the ship, or you could also say to the top of the ship. So currently, Coral Queen is the only government ship available to port people from Port Blair to Havelock. Usually, it covers the distance in 3 or to 4 hours, but depending on the weather condition, it might take some more time. This was our first experience and it was absolutely explicit. So finally, we have sailed on to our final destination from Port Blair, and we're gonna spend our next complete 3 days over here. And we'll be covering both the beautiful beaches of this place. So after arriving, our driver picked us up from Havelock Jetty, and as we were a bit tired and had our entire luggage with us, so we asked him to directly take us to our hotel. The hotel was beautifully designed in hut style, which was a plus point of our stay in this hotel because it was entirely giving us beach vibes. So over here you could easily get such beautifully designed luxurious hotels at pretty good price, and also the staff is very polite and quite helpful. Now we enter our room. It was warm and cozy with a wide window on the side of the room, which was giving us a complete beautiful view of our balcony. As we just had 3 days and a lot to cover on this island, so we changed and got ourselves ready for Radhanagar Beach. Before arriving over here, we researched a lot and we came on to the conclusion of exploring the island on Scooty. There are several Scooty renting shops near the main market and also near Havelock Jetty.
बैठो सुन, यहाँ से सीधा जाके उधर है ना, इस साइड जाना है सनसेट। बैठो सुन।
और ले जी। सनसेट गाड़ी आएगी।
So after renting the Scooty, we directly headed towards the beach, which was 15 to 20 minutes away from our hotel. So till now, if you're loving the journey, then do not forget to subscribe to the channel so that you get notified for all the new videos. So to visit Havelock, all the bookings has to be done for about 3 to 4 months beforehand in advance, and the best season to visit over there is currently in December till February. For all the bookings and ferry related queries, you can visit to Andaman and Nicobar's official website. Also, I will mention the link in the description down below. So here we are at the parking of the beach, and after entering the premises of the beach, there was a name entry booth where a lady was sitting and writing down all the names of the visitors just for safety purposes. So finally the wait is over, and here we are at the most famous beach of all the beaches in India, and also it has been recognized as a blue flag beach by the government itself because of its up to the mark cleanliness and maintenance. Even on Google it ranks somewhere around 5th position of all the certified blue flag beaches of India. But sometimes knowing through the internet or by someone else's mouth is just not enough. I would say by coming yourself over here, and for me it is like actually seeing the beach, actually seeing its beauty, its incredible beauty, made me fall in love with it for real. It was just so beautiful. I could spend my whole life over here. That would be just over exaggerating, I know, but it was absolutely clean. The water was just super clean. I could not differentiate between the sky and the water. It was both were having the same shades. It was just so beautiful, beautiful. Radhanagar Beach is also famous for its sunset viewpoint. So while we were waiting for the sun to completely set and we could have that incredible beautiful sunset view, we made sandcastles, carved name on the sands, played with the waves, collected corals and enjoyed a lot more over there. And we could not help but stay over there until the sun was completely set. So guys, अभी हम राधानगर बीच पे हैं, जो कि बहुत ही फेमस सनसेट पॉइंट है हैवलॉक आइलैंड का. और यहाँ से व्यू देखिए आप, कितना ज़्यादा सुंदर है. और यहाँ पे सब लोग मस्ती कर रहे हैं. हम लोग बीच में अभी नहाए थे, जैसे कि आप देख सकते हैं बहुत ज़्यादा भीग रखी है. तो हम लोग पूरा सी में नहा के अच्छे से बैठे हुए थे. अब सनसेट होने वाला है, हम सनसेट का व्यू एंजॉय करेंगे. टडा, इट्स आवर फर्स्ट ऑफिशियल गुड मॉर्निंग इन हैवलॉक आइलैंड. सो वी थॉट what better way to start it with a yummy breakfast, and we went to the most recommended restaurant of this place, Anju Coco restaurant. This place is styled in slightly Tibetan form, and the sitting area is divided into two parts. On one side of the sitting area there are chairs and tables arranged beautifully to sit over them, and on the other side there are floor tables and cushions arranged to sit. So to match with the vibe of this place, we chose the floor cushions. अभी यहाँ का मेन्यू बहुत ज़्यादा डिलीशियस है, तो मेरे पति देव बहुत ज़्यादा कंफ्यूज हो रहे हैं कि क्या खाएं। ये देखो कैसे पेज पलटे जा रहे हैं, एक जगह पे रुका नहीं जा रहा है। वैसे सही में ये देखने में सब कुछ बहुत डिलीशियस लग रहा है, अभी देखते हैं, खा के देखते हैं कैसा होता है। क्या मंगवाना है फिर, जल्दी बताओ। ये था पनीर बटर मसाला, फिश, दाल, चावल, जो कि अब ख़त्म होने वाला है, और ये हमारा दूसरा प्लेटर आ चुका है। इसमें है कि पास्ता, मेयोनीज, ब्रेड एंड फिश कटलेट, काइंड ऑफ सिज़लर, फिश सिज़लर।
सो आफ्टर हैविंग दिस जैम पैक्ड ब्रेकफास्ट, वी हेडेड directly towards our second destination for the next morning, that was Kala Patthar Beach. Kala Patthar Beach is famous for its sunrise viewpoint, so we had to reach over here early in the morning.
It is quite different from the prior Radhanagar Beach. Both of them are so unique in their own way that they are entirely so beautiful. Both of the beaches can be covered in a single day. In the morning, you can have a beautiful sunrise view at the Kala Patthar Beach, and in the evening, you can go to Radhanagar Beach and have that incredible sunset view through your eyes. So with that, it would bring our second day in Havelock to an end. And if you liked the video, do not forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel so that you get notified for all the upcoming videos and all the upcoming next episodes of our Andaman and Nicobar vlog. And yes, also do not forget to comment on the video how you liked it. And until then, stay tuned for more.